that's a category that exists. Now, I don't actually remember the birth of Takatu Percent, though. I remember Timpani was doing it as kind of a proof of concept of just like, you know, we don't have randomizers for Odyssey. The game's kind of new. So let's impose our own way of making a randomizer. So Takatu Percent is this idea that there's a little bird that lives in the kingdom, all of the kingdoms. And when you talk to him, he just gives you the name of a moon. And you can do that 3 times. So it's kind of like a hint system. It's like, if you don't know where moons are in the game, at least you have the name of it to kind of go off of to maybe help you out a little bit. And so we use like any of the moons that he gives are random, right? So it basically became a category that, you know, changed the game up every single time you played it. And that's why it was fun. So when you say what are the most popular categories, definitely the main board. But category extensions are when, like, speedrunners kind of get tired of the grind, you know? Like, because it's such a grindy game and because you can hit plateaus so fast, category extensions kind of spice it up a little bit, you know? You know, at the end of the day, you consider how much time it's actually saving, and we're talking about, like, maybe 10, 15. I guess for the case of 1.0, it was, like, 30 seconds total. But, yeah. You know, when you first start out, 30 seconds is not going to make the difference between, like, your first run and the world record, right? Like, if the world record is like 1:00 and your first run is like a 1:30, 1:40, 1:50, maybe 2 hour time, that 30 seconds isn't going to help you, right? It doesn't matter. So it's the same as all hobbies, right? Like if you want to get into drawing, you need a pencil and paper. You don't need like an expensive drawing tablet, for example. Like you know, all hobbies are going to be like that. There are even things that are for complete free that I wouldn't recommend doing right off the bat. Like playing this game in Chinese is the fastest way to play the game, but if you don't know how to navigate the menus, you're going to get frustrated because you're like, well, I need to reset my run, but I don't know how to get there because I'm in Chinese. So, like, start your speedruns in English and then switch over to Chinese when you remember the menus, right? Like, definitely, you know, do what is available to you and what's easiest until you can kind of graduate into that when you've actually put some passion into it, right? Honestly, the simple answer for this run in Takatu, I play in English because I can read English. Takatu is a bird that literally speaks whatever language you have set, right? So if he's giving me, like you can see right here on the screen, a treasure made from coins, if that was in Chinese, I wouldn't know what moon that is, right? So the reason that we play Takatu in English is because I can read it. So you would play in whatever your local language is, right? Would it be faster to play in Chinese? Technically, yes. but until I learn Chinese, I'm not getting that time save, you know what I mean? So when it comes to having to actually understand the game, you know, you're kind of limited by that, right? But so Japanese is probably the language you saw Fur and Nycro playing in the last run.
It definitely was. Because back then, people thought it was still the fastest.
It was very weird. We must have done like some preliminary language testing and just decided outright that, yep, Japanese is the fastest. Chinese is the fastest for the first 3 kingdoms, but we're not going to test past that. We don't need to. We just know that Japanese is the fastest. That's all. It wasn't until like I think early 2020 or something like that that we decided to retest all the languages, and it was like, so we all got bamboozled by that. It was like, oh, thank you for the free second of time save that we've all been completely avoiding. And it's so funny that speedrunning happens like that, right? Like something sitting like right out in the open that we all just take for granted.